वेलकम टू अनअकैडमी गेट MEXCPI. दिस इज योर एजुकेटर अप्रूप राव एंड यू आर वॉचिंग द लेक्चर सीरीज ऑफ मशीन डिजाइन. वी आर गोइंग टू कम्प्लीट द सिलेबस ऑफ मशीन डिजाइन एंड इट इज यूजफुल फॉर ऑल द स्टूडेंट्स प्रिपेयरिंग फॉर एनी कॉम्पिटेटिव एग्जाम बेस्ड ऑन मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग. नाउ प्लीज हिट द लाइक बटन एंड शेयर द लिंक विद ऑल योर फ्रेंड्स एंड लेट देम नो दैट टूडे वी आर गोइंग टू कवर the concept of centrifugal clutch. Today we are going to design centrifugal clutch, which is an automatic clutch. Okay, so it's an interesting concept that we are going to learn today. So please hit the like button and share as much as you can. Call all your friends live. Call all your friends online. Let them know that we are live. Good evening, good evening, good evening, good evening, Dhananjay. Good evening, Parth. Good evening, Bittu. Now those of you who are watching me for the first time, let me introduce myself. My name is Apurup Rao. All India rank 320 from GATE Mechanical. I've done my M.Tech from IIT Kharagpur and my specialization was mechanical systems design. Then in my final year, I was recruited by Mahindra Research Valley. I worked there as deputy manager and my work was related to the design and analysis of the body parts of car. XUV, KUV, TUV, all these vehicles are designed at Mahindra Research Valley. So I was there for 2 years, then I quit my job and I started teaching. I've been teaching for more than 6 years now and I teach subjects related to design, SOM, MD, EM as well as TOM. So beta, don't forget to hit the like button and share the link with all your friends. And as you can see that and my entire experience is based on design, I am going to teach this subject in a great manner, in a practical manner. I am going to give you practical examples. I am going to relate these concepts with their practical applications. Okay. So, beta, this is the lecture series of machine design where we are covering the entire syllabus of machine design. Every day from Monday to Saturday, we take classes from 7:30 p.m. to 8:45 p.m. And we also have practice sessions on Unacademy from 9 p.m. to 10 p.m. Whenever we need to practice numericals, we conduct these special classes on Unacademy, which are completely free of cost from 9 p.m. to 10 p.m. And today also we have a practice session from 9 p.m. to 10 p.m. So, beta, tell all your friends to join. Happy Vishwakarma Puja Aniket. Happy Vishwakarma to all of the mechanical engineers. Good evening, Adil. Good evening. Now, beta, if you want to download my ebooks and PDF notes, then you can just go to tinyurl.com/approve10 where I have uploaded all the PDF notes and I have made a digital book of engineering mechanics. Now, what is this digital book, beta? It is a form of Excel sheet. It is in the form of Excel sheet. So there is an Excel sheet of engineering mechanics that you will find where you will find lecture by lecture the YouTube class link and the PDF notes link. So I have taken 38 lectures of engineering mechanics. I have completed the entire syllabus and I have solved many problems. So you can refer all these lectures by lecture. YouTube link is there and PDF link is also there. So whenever you have a doubt in any topic of engineering mechanics, you can just open this Excel sheet and you will find the YouTube class of that lecture and you will also find the PDF notes of that lecture. The link is given in the Excel sheet. Click on the link and you will be redirected towards the site. So don't forget to tell about this to your friends also. And in the same way, we also have a digital book of machine design. So this course is ongoing, beta. So only 7 lectures till now. So you can find all those lectures here. Aap un sare lectures ko yahan pe dekh sakte hain. 8 lectures. This is the 9th lecture. So you'll find all the 8 lectures in the Excel sheet. You will find the YouTube class link and you will also find the PDF notes link. So don't forget to watch these lectures. And beta, if you want to study with us in a more personalized manner, then you can just come to Unacademy Plus. This Unacademy Plus subscription will give you an edge that you need in order to get into PSUs and IITs. If you are one of the, you know, if you are just like me, an average student who who is preparing for GATE and who wants to get into PSU or IIT. I was also one of them. I was also an average student. I also started getting in coaching beta in my final year. So if you also want that extra help that you need to get into IITs or PSU, then you can just come to Unacademy Plus subscription. You will get live classes in English as well as in Hindi. You will get all the doubt clearing sessions. So whenever you will have doubt beta, you can get it clear live in class. You will have weekly tests, you will have rank improvement batch, and you will also have crash courses. From 21st September, we are starting a crash course for GATE. So beta, if you want to join that crash course, don't forget to subscribe to Unacademy Plus using my code. What is my code, beta? Approved10. So beta, from 21st September, we are starting a crash course. And all the top educators of mechanical engineering are taking this crash course. So if you want to learn from the best of mechanical engineering of India, then beta, get into Unacademy Plus and learn from the very best. Be the very best. Good evening, Mahadev Prasad. Good evening. Good evening, Deepthi. Good evening, Shankar. Good evening, Prem. Good evening, Abid. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. So now, beta, we were studying the design of clutch. What is clutch? It is a mechanical device used to connect or disconnect the driving shaft and the driven shaft so that the driven shaft can be stopped without stopping the driving shaft. So in automobile, the clutch connects the engine shaft and the transmission shaft. So you can stop the transmission without stopping the engine shaft. Okay. Then we saw that there are two types of clutch, positive clutch and friction clutch. Positive clutch means there is no slip during engagement. And friction clutch means there will be some slip during the engagement. So we saw the advantage and disadvantage of both these clutches. We saw the difference in both these clutches. Then I told you that we only have friction clutches in our syllabus, and there are three types of friction clutch: plate clutch, cone clutch, and centrifugal clutch. मैंने आपको बताया था कि हमारे syllabus में हमको सिर्फ friction clutch consider करना है, जो तीन type के होते हैं, plate, cone, and centrifugal. Then friction plate clutch is also of two types: single plate and multi plate. तो हमने single plate clutch का design देख लिया. We have seen the design of single plate clutch. We have seen the working. We have seen the construction. We have derived the design equations. We have also solved numericals from single plate clutch. We have also seen multi plate clutch. There is not too much difference between single plate clutch and multi plate clutch. We have seen the difference between them and the application of single and multi plate clutch. We have also seen in the last lecture the construction, working, and design of cone clutch, right? So, Divita, plate clutch or cone clutch हमने पढ़ लिया है. Plate clutch and cone clutch we have done. We are done. And now we need to start with centrifugal clutch. So today we are going to cover centrifugal clutch. We are going to see the construction of centrifugal clutch. We are going to see the design of centrifugal clutch. We are going to see the application of centrifugal clutch. And then we are going to discuss what are the advantages of centrifugal clutch. Okay. So beta, this is the schematic diagram of a centrifugal clutch. Okay. What are the major parts? There is driving shaft and driven shaft. This driven shaft is connected to a drum, rotating drum. Okay. Now, there are shoes connected to the driving shaft via spring. Jo shoe hai, wo spring ke through driving shaft se connected hai. Now, here, the contact between the driving shaft and driven shaft will take place through these shoes. Yahan pe driving shaft aur driven shaft ke beech mein jo contact aayega, वो इन शूज के थ्रू आएगा. द ड्राइविंग शाफ्ट विल बी कनेक्टेड टू द ड्रिवन शाफ्ट व्हेन दिस शूज विल बी कनेक्टेड टू दिस ड्रम. ड्राइविंग शाफ्ट इज कनेक्टेड टू शूज, ड्रिवन शाफ्ट इज कनेक्टेड टू ड्रम. ड्राइविंग शाफ्ट इज कंटिन्यूअसली रोटेटिंग. सो व्हेन द शू विल गेट कनेक्टेड टू द ड्रम, द ड्रिवन शाफ्ट विल ऑल्सो रोटेट, राइट? नाउ बेटा, सेंट्रीफ्यूगल क्लच इज एन ऑटोमेटिक क्लच. नाउ लेट्स फर्स्ट अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट डू आई मीन बाय ऑटोमेटिक. See, in case of plate clutch and cone clutch, in order to engage or disengage, we need to apply the force manually. For example, in cars, if there is a manual clutch, plate clutch, then what you do? You need to press the pedal manually in order to disengage the clutch. So the engagement and disengagement takes place when you manually apply the force. But in case of centrifugal clutch, the engagement and disengagement depends upon the speed of the driving shaft. And it takes place automatically. It does not require manual intervention. यानी कि यहां पे आपको W force apply करने की जरूरत नहीं है engagement या disengagement के लिए. यहां पे जो engagement होगा वो driving shaft की speed से होगा, driving shaft की speed पे depend करेगा. So this is completely an automatic clutch. Automatic means you don't need to apply the force of engagement or disengagement manually. The force will be created by the speed of the driving shaft. So is this point clear to everyone? What do we mean by automatic clutch? Automatic clutch बोलने से हमारा क्या मतलब है? क्या ये point सबको clear है? How this works, how the engagement or disengagement takes place, that we will see later. First, I want you all to understand what do I mean by an automatic clutch. Automatic clutch, अगर मैं बोलता हूँ, तो उसका मतलब क्या है? ये आप लोगों को clear होना चाहिए. Good evening, Shankar. Good evening, Shubham, Kuldeep, Uma, Umesh, Ashwin, Dharmendra, Siddharth. So, is this clear? Yes, it is clear to everyone that the centrifugal clutch is an automatic clutch. Good evening, Rajshekhar. ठीक है, ठीक है. अब बेटा, let's first understand the construction and working of centrifugal clutch through animation. पहले एक animation देख लेते हैं. We'll get some idea that we will talk about it in detail. We will derive the mathematical equation. ठीक है? तो एक animation के through पहले समझते हैं कि centrifugal clutch का construction और working कैसा है. Okay? So let's first understand the construction. So बेटा, this is the driving member and this is the driven member. Okay? This is the driving shaft. This is the driven shaft. You can see that the driving shaft is connected to spring and the spring is connected to the brake shoe. Okay. And the driven member also has friction lining. Okay. Inside this drum, there is friction lining. Now understand, beta, understand the working. So look at this, beta. Right now the shaft is rotating. Right now the shaft is rotating. Now understand, when the shaft will rotate, yahan pe achhi tarah dhyan se dekho. Understand this. Understand this. When the shaft will rotate, when the speed is low, when the speed is low, there is not much force on these shoes. Okay. When this shaft will start rotating, there will be an outward force on the shoe. Right. Jab ye shaft rotate karna chalu karega, tab in shoes ke upar ek outward force lagega. When the shaft will start rotating, there will be an outward force acting on the shoe. What is this force called? Is force ko hum kya bolte hain? Beta, you might have learned this in your school also. If you are rotating a stone by connecting it to a string in a circular path, the string experiences an outward force. The stone experiences an outward force. What is that force, beta? What is that force? Us force ko hum kya bolte hain? Us force ko hum kya bolte hain? Jab hum ek stone ko एक सर्कुलर पाथ में मूव करते हैं, स्टोन के ऊपर बाहर की तरफ एक फोर्स लगता है, दैट फोर्स इज कॉल्ड सेंट्रीफ्यूगल फोर्स. सो हियर अंडरस्टैंड दिस थिंग, द ड्राइविंग शाफ्ट इज रोटेटिंग एंड द शूज आर कनेक्टेड टू द ड्राइविंग शाफ्ट वाया सेंट्रीफ्यूगल फोर्स. यस विवेक, सेंट्रीफ्यूगल फोर्स. सो बेटा, नाउ द शूज आर एक्सपीरियंसिंग अ सेंट्रीफ्यूगल फोर्स. शूज आर कनेक्टेड वाया स्प्रिंग, सॉरी, शूज आर कनेक्टेड वाया स्प्रिंग. And when you are rotating the shaft, the shoes are experiencing a centrifugal force outward. So, ye force jo hai, inko bahar ki taraf dhikel raha hai. This force is pushing the shoes outward. And when the speed will increase beyond a particular value, the shoes will be connected and the driven shaft will start to rotate. Understand, understand, understand. Right now it is rotating at a low speed. So, the force is not enough. So, the shoes are not connected. Now we are increasing the speed. Now look at this. Now look at this. Now look at this. Understand this, beta. Dekho yahan pe dhyan se dekho. The shoe is right now not connected. If you are increasing the force, then the shoe will experience outward force and it will get connected to the driven member. And now the driven member is also rotating. Ab ye driven member jo hai, ye bhi ghoom raha hai. Yahan pe dhyan se dekho, beta. Dhyan se dekho. Dekho. Dhyan se dekho. Dhyan se dekho. To abhi driving member ghoom raha hai. Right now, driving member is rotating. There is some force on shoe, but it is not enough. Now I am increasing the speed, so the shoe is going outward. Now it is connected, and the driven member is started to move. Hagening. So is it clear? Is the working clear to everyone? ये working सबको clear है. ये working सबको clear है. Is this clear? Look at this. Right now it is rotating at low speed. Now I am increasing the speed. So it gets connected to the driven member, and then the driven member starts to rotate. So is this point clear? Is this construction and working clear? Yes. Very good. Okay. So now, beta, let's understand mathematically what is the concept behind the centrifugal clutch. So in order to understand the concept of centrifugal clutch, I have considered one particular shoe. ठीक है, मैंने एक पर्टिकुलर शू कंसिडर किया है. ओके, नाउ लेट्स से द शाफ्ट स्टार्टेड टू रोटेट. सो द शू इज एक्सपीरियंसिंग टू फोर्सेस. व्हेन द शाफ्ट विल स्टार्ट टू रोटेट, द शू विल एक्सपीरियंस टू फोर्सेस. देर विल बी वन फोर्स एक्टिंग आउटवर्ड विच विल बी द सेंट्रीफ्यूगल फोर्स. ठीक है, and there will be one force acting inward which will be the spring force. Okay, to yahan pe dhyan se samjho beta, fc is the centrifugal force and fs is the spring force. There will be weight of shoe also, which is very negligible. So I am not considering the weight of shoe. Okay, in the analysis, I am ignoring the weight of shoe. I am not considering the weight of shoe. Okay, now understand. Right now, the shaft is rotating at very low speed. Okay, so at low speed, FC is equal to FS. So net force between shoe and drum is equal to what? Net force is equal to zero, right? Net force will be equal to zero, na? FC minus FS, it is equal to zero. And if net force is zero, there will be no engagement. ठीक है? Now beta, let's say we started to increase the centrifugal force. Okay? अब हम क्या कर रहे हैं? Centrifugal force जो है वो धीरे धीरे increase कर रहे हैं. So if the centrifugal force is increasing, speed of the shaft is increasing. Agar hum speed of shaft ko dheere dheere increase karenge, centrifugal force will increase. What is centrifugal force? Centrifugal force equation is mr omega square, where omega is the speed of the shaft. So if omega increases, if the speed of shaft increases, centrifugal force increases. Understand this beta. Fc is equal to mr omega square. So as omega increases, fc increases, and if fc increases, fs will also increase, right? Ab isko main ek graph se samjhata hu. Let me explain this concept using a graph. Okay, so let's say we are drawing a graph between fc and fs with respect to omega. Omega ke saath fc aur fs kaise change ho rahe hain, I am drawing a graph based on that. Okay, so initially when fc is zero, fs is also zero, hai na? At omega equal to zero, fc will be zero, fs will also be zero. Theek hai? Now as you start increasing the omega, FC will increase and FS will also increase, है ना? तो किसी भी स्पीड पे अगर आप देखोगे FC और FS दोनों बराबर रहेंगे. एट एनी स्पीड द सेंट्रीफ्यूगल फोर्स एक्टिंग आउटसाइड एंड स्प्रिंग फोर्स एक्टिंग इनसाइड विल बी इक्वल एंड ऑपोजिट. सो द नेट फोर्स विल रिमेन जीरो. द नेट फोर्स विल रिमेन जीरो. द नेट फोर्स विल रिमेन जीरो. ठीक है. तो बेटा अब व्हाट विल हैपन, देयर विल बी अ पॉइंट व्हेन द स्प्रिंग फोर्स विल बिकम मैक्सिमम. सो लेट्स से एक पर्टिकुलर स्पीड पे, मान लो ये वो स्पीड है ओमेगा वन, वेयर द स्प्रिंग फोर्स बिकेम मैक्सिमम. स्प्रिंग फोर्स क्या हो गया? मैक्सिमम हो गया. ओके, दिस इज व्हाट, दिस इज द मैक्सिमम स्प्रिंग फोर्स. ठीक है, दिस इज द मैक्सिमम स्प्रिंग फोर्स, दिस इज एफ एस मैक्सिमम. ओके, नाउ आफ्टर दिस व्हाट इज गोइंग टू हैपन, इफ आई इंक्रीज माय स्पीड फर्दर, ओमेगा वन स्पीड तक एफ सी एंड एफ एस बोथ आर इक्वल, बट आफ्टर ओमेगा वन इफ आई इंक्रीज माई स्पीड देन एफ सी विल इंक्रीज but fs will remain same. So at any speed omega 2, at any speed omega 2, fc will be mr omega 2 square, but what will be fs, what will be fs, fs will be mr omega 1 square. yahan pe dekho beta, yahan pe dekho, इस पॉइंट तक FC और FS बराबर थे, है ना? इस पॉइंट तक FC और FS बराबर थे, तो इस पॉइंट पे FS was MR omega 1 square. Now after this FS remains constant, it will remain MR omega 1 square, but FC will increase. So if I am talking about omega 2 speed, FC will be MR omega 2 square. FS will be MR omega 1 square. So now there is a net force between the shoe and the drum, right? Ab ek net force act karega shoe aur drum ke beech mein. Now there will be a net force and this net force will engage the shoe and the drum. In order to engage the shoe with the drum, we need some force, hai na? दो सर्फेसेस को आपस में एंगेज करना है ताकि दूसरा भी घूम सके, तो आपको दोनों को एक फोर्स लगा के एंगेज करना पड़ेगा. यू विल हैव टू एंगेज बोथ ऑफ देम बाय अप्लाइंग सम फोर्स, राइट, बाय अप्लाइंग सम फोर्स. सो बेटा इन दिस केस एज वी कीप इंक्रीजिंग द स्पीड अप टू ओमेगा वन, द नेट फोर्स इज जीरो बिकॉज एफ सी एंड एफ एस बोथ आर equal and opposite. But at omega 1 speed, the spring force becomes maximum at omega 1. At omega 1, यहां पे ध्यान से देखो बेटा, at omega 1, fs becomes maximum. So after omega 1, speed shoe engages with drum. Omega 1 speed तक FC और FS दोनों बराबर थे. I was increasing omega, so FC was increasing, FS was increasing. FC was increasing, FS was increasing. At omega 1 speed, FS became maximum. Up to this point, both were equal and opposite. Now after omega 1, if I increase my speed, only FC will increase, FS will remain constant. So now there is a net force between the shoe and the drum which is going to engage the clutch. So beta, here the engagement will depend upon this omega 1 speed. At omega 1 speed, the engagement will start. Omega 1 wo speed hai jab engagement chalu hoga. Omega 1 tak FC and FS both are equal, but after omega 1 there will be a net force between FC and FS. So beta, up to this point no engagement, up to this point no engagement, after this point there will be engagement. So beta, here there will be engagement between shoe and clutch based on omega 1. So this is an automatic clutch, you don't need to apply any force. The force is created by the centrifugal force itself, speed of shaft itself, and the engagement will take place automatically depending upon the value of omega. आप omega 1 अपने हिसाब से set कर लो. You set the value of omega 1 according to your need, and beta, when the speed will increase beyond omega 1, it will automatically engage, and when the speed will reduce, then it will automatically disengage. ठीक है. So now beta, what are the applications of this clutch? यहाँ पे application क्या है, centrifugal clutch का application क्या है? Understand this. This is very important to understand. Applications of centrifugal clutch. ठीक है. Centrifugal clutch का application क्या है? So the first application is, it is used in light duty vehicles. Such as mopeds. Mopeds मतलब क्या बेटा? Activa, scooty, etc. Okay. And golf carts देखा होगा सबने. Golf खेलते time ball जब एक जगह से दूसरी जगह चली जाती है, so in order to move the people, they use a very lightweight vehicle which is known as golf cart. Okay. तो गोल्फ कार्ट इज ऑल्सो एन एग्जाम्पल ऑफ सेंट्रिफ्यूगल क्लच. ओके, गोल्फ कार्ट इज ऑल्सो इन गोल्फ कार्ट सेंट्रिफ्यूगल क्लच इज यूज. ठीक है. तो एक तो लाइट वेट व्हीकल में इट इज यूज. सेकेंड, इन हैवी ड्यूटी मशीनरीज. It is used as a safety device as it allows the engine or motor, it allows the engine or motor to start at नो लोड कंडीशन. अब यहां पे एक चीज समझो बेटा, दिस सेकेंड पॉइंट लेट्स अंडरस्टैंड. व्हाट डज इट मीन. सेकेंड पॉइंट समझ लेते हैं. इन हैवी ड्यूटी मशीनरीज द सेंट्रिफ्यूगल क्लच एक्ट्स एज अ सेफ्टी डिवाइस. ओके, अब ये सेफ्टी डिवाइस के जैसा कैसे काम करता है, लेट्स अंडरस्टैंड. ओके, लेट्स से आई एम यूजिंग अ वेरी हैवी मशीन. ओके, लेट्स से आई एम यूजिंग अ वेरी एक एग्जांपल लेते हैं. लेट्स से वी आर यूजिंग अ क्रेन. ओके, मान लो एक क्रेन है. ओके, इट इज लिफ्टिंग अ वेरी हैवी वेट. द क्रेन इज लिफ्टिंग अ वेरी हैवी वेट. सो व्हेन आई स्टार्ट द इंजन ऑफ द क्रेन एंड एज सून एज आई स्टार्ट द इंजन, इफ आई कनेक्ट द क्लच, व्हाट इज गोइंग टू हैपन इफ द क्लच इज कनेक्टेड एज सून एज द इंजन स्टार्ट्स, देन बेटा the engine will not be able to produce that much power, the engine will not be able to develop that much power which is required to move the crane, because right now the crane is lifting a very heavy weight, so it requires a lot of power to move the crane. So beta, the engine needs some time to gather that much power, to produce that much power, to develop that much power in order to move the crane. So until the engine develops that much power, the clutch should not be engaged, है ना? आप ये चाहते हो कि इंजन को थोड़ा टाइम मिले. यू वॉन्ट द इंजन टू टेक सम टाइम टू डेवलप दैट मच पावर इन ऑर्डर टू मूव द क्रेन. सो बेटा, देयर वी विल प्लेस अ सेंट्रिफ्यूगल क्लच. सो व्हाट सेंट्रिफ्यूगल क्लच विल डू, अंटिल एंड अनलेस द स्पीड इंक्रीजेस बियॉन्ड अ पर्टिकुलर पॉइंट, द क्लच विल नॉट एंगेज. सो अंटिल the power is enough to move the crane, the clutch will not engage and the crane will not move. You might have experienced this. Agar aap maan lo char log baith ke ek bike mein jaate ho, let's say 4 people are sitting on a bike. Okay, so if you start the bike and without accelerating without accelerating, if you start moving the bike by directly connecting the clutch, what will happen? The bike will not be able to produce that much power and it will stop. है ना? अगर आप टाइम नहीं दोगे इंजन को, जैसे ही चालू करोगे आप आगे बढ़ने की कोशिश करोगे, इंजन बैठ जाएगा. सो व्हाट यू विल डू, फर्स्ट यू विल स्टार्ट द इंजन, यू विल नॉट एंगेज द इंजन, यू विल नॉट एंगेज द क्लच एंड यू विल एक्सेलरेट द इंजन, यू विल टेक सम टाइम एंड आफ्टर दैट यू विल एंगेज द क्लच, देन द बॉडी विल, देन द बाइक विल मूव बिकॉज इट हैज नाउ दैट मच पावर. अब उतना पावर आ चुका है, अब उतना पावर आ चुका है, ठीक है. सो बेटा नाउ डू यू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ दिस सेकेंड, दिस सेकेंड पॉइंट दैट इट वर्क्स एज अ सेफ्टी डिवाइस, इट वर्क्स एज अ सेफ्टी डिवाइस इन हैवी ड्यूटी मशीनरीज. ये क्लियर है, ये क्लियर है आपको? यस 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 सर, यस यस सर, यस यस सर. So do you understand the examples of centrifugal clutch? Do you understand the advantage of centrifugal clutch? Where it will be used? Application part clear? Beta, it is very important because there have been theory questions from these points. In points ke upar theory question aa chuka hai. Theek hai? In points ke upar theory question aa chuka hai. So beta, it is very important to understand this concept. Okay? So beta, it is used in low duty, light duty vehicles such as mopeds and golf carts. And it is also used in heavy duty machineries as a safety device. Very good Bittu, very good Prem, very good Nikhil, very good Mahadev Prasad. Okay, okay, okay. So we are clear about the design and construction of centrifugal clutch. Now we are going to derive the equation of torque for the centrifugal clutch. Ab hum kya karne wale hain? Ab hum iski ek equation derive karne wale hain. अब हम इसकी एक इक्वेशन डिराइव करने वाले हैं टॉर्क ट्रांसफर की. ओके, सो लेट्स डिराइव दैट इक्वेशन ऑफ टॉर्क ट्रांसफर. लेट्स डिराइव दैट इक्वेशन ऑफ टॉर्क ट्रांसफर, राइट? टॉर्क ट्रांसफर की इक्वेशन डिराइव करें बेटा. चलो 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 चलो. सो द कंस्ट्रक्शन एंड वर्किंग इज क्लियर. नाउ वी विल डिराइव द इक्वेशन ऑफ टॉर्क ट्रांसफर. ओके, सो इन ऑर्डर टू डिराइव द इक्वेशन ऑफ टॉर्क ट्रांसफर, फर्स्ट वी नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड द पैरामीटर्स ऑफ द सेंट्रीफ्यूगल क्लच. ओके, सो लेट्स से बेटा there are n number of shoes. Let's say there are n number of shoes. Okay. For example, यहां मैंने example में कितने number of shoes लिए हैं? यहां मैंने diagram में लिए हैं चार number of shoes. So I am saying that there are n number of shoes and m is the mass of, beta, ignore these kind of people. Bittu, ignore these type of people who are just there to spam the live chat. Okay. Thank you so much, Ameya. Thank you so much. So mass of each shoe is mkg. Okay. So n is number of shoes, m is mass of each shoe. Okay. Now understand the radius. There are two radiuses. One is the inner radius of drum. This is the center point. So center point se leke inner surface of drum. This is the inner radius of drum. RD. RD is what? RD is the inner radius of drum. Theek hai? And one is the radius of CG of shoe. The radius of CG of shoe in the engaged position. अब ये वाला radius क्यों चाहिए बेटा? Why do we need this radius? Because when we will apply the centrifugal force mr omega square, when you will apply centrifugal force mr omega square, where you will assume the mass is? Mass कितने distance पे assume करेंगे? We will assume that the mass is at this much distance, O to G, which is RG. Okay. So RG is what? It is the radius of CG of shoe in engaged position. ठीक है? It is the radius of CG of shoe in engaged position. ठीक है? Now beta, now beta, now beta. Omega 1 is the speed at which engagement starts. 0 से लेके ओमेगा वन स्पीड तक कोई एंगेजमेंट नहीं था, अप टू जीरो, फ्रॉम जीरो टू ओमेगा वन देर वॉज नो एंगेजमेंट, आफ्टर ओमेगा वन द एंगेजमेंट स्टार्ट, राइट, आफ्टर ओमेगा वन द एंगेजमेंट स्टार्ट. सो ओमेगा वन इज वॉट, इट इज द स्पीड एट विच एंगेजमेंट स्टार्ट एंड इट इज ऑल्सो द स्पीड एट विच एफ एस इज मैक्सिमम. ठीक है, इट इज द स्पीड एट विच एफ एस बिकम्स मैक्सिमम, राइट, एंड ओमेगा टू इज लेट्स से द रनिंग स्पीड. ओमेगा टू क्या है बेटा? रनिंग स्पीड. ओमेगा टू क्या है? इट इज रनिंग स्पीड, मतलब ओमेगा टू जो है उस स्पीड पे क्लच चल रहा है एंड इट इज ग्रेटर देन ओमेगा वन. सीजी मीन सेंटर ऑफ ग्रेविटी रे भाई. सीजी मतलब क्या? जहां मास को हम लोग लोकेटेड मानते हैं, सीजी इज सेंटर ऑफ ग्रेविटी. ओके, ऑल राइट, ऑल राइट. सो बेटा दीज आर द पैरामीटर्स एंड वी आर गोइंग टू डिराइव द इक्वेशन ऑफ टॉर्क बेस्ड ऑन दीज पैरामीटर. ओके, so let's start the derivation, let's start the derivation. Okay, now beta, understand, right now the clutch is operating at omega 2 speed. ठीक है, अभी जो speed है वो omega 2 है. So at omega 2 speed what will be the centrifugal force? Centrifugal force will be mrg omega 1 square, है ना, for one shoe, for each shoe, हर एक shoe के ऊपर. अभी यहां पे एक shoe के बारे में बात चल रही बेटा, we are talking about one shoe right now. Okay, so बेटा at omega 2 speed fc will be equal to mrg omega 1 square, centrifugal force on each shoe will be mrg, omega 2 square, right. What will be the spring force? Yes, Vivek की बात सुन लो दोस्तों, Vivek की बात सुन लो. Omega, like button दबा दो सबके सब. Hit the like button everyone. Make it above 100. अब बेटा यहाँ पे ध्यान से देखो. At omega 2 speed, FC is mr omega 2 square, but FS will remain mr omega 1 square ना. FS जो है वो omega 1 पे maximum हो गया था. FS became maximum at omega 1, fs became maximum at omega 1, so fs value will be mr omega 1 square, right. This is the maximum spring force, this is the maximum spring force, it became maximum at omega 1, so after omega 1 it doesn't matter what is the speed, fs will remain same, mr omega 1 square. ठीक है, after omega 1 only fc is increasing, fs will remain constant. यहां पे देखो fs जो है वो constant हो गया, fc बढ़ रहा है but fs constant है. What is fs maximum? mr omega 1 square ना, इस speed पे जितना fc उतना ही fs, तो mr omega 1 square, right. So now beta, what is the net force? Between shoe and drum, net force between shoe and drum कितना है? Net force between shoe and drum will be FC minus FS, means mRg omega 2 square minus omega 1 square. Net force will be mRg omega 2 square minus omega 1 square. Now if net force is this, if normal force is this, what will be the friction force? Friction force will be equal to mu into m into rg omega 2 square minus omega 1 square, right? Mu into m into rg omega 2 square minus omega 1 square, right? आपका फ्रिक्शन फोर्स क्या होगा? म्यू एम आर जी ओमेगा टू स्क्वायर माइनस ओमेगा वन स्क्वायर. ओके, Now, beta, if this is the friction force, what will be the torque transfer? This friction force is acting here. The friction force is acting here, beta. Friction force जो है वो यहां लग रहा है. It is acting between the shoe and the drum. This is the friction force. So it is acting at what distance? RD distance. So what will be the torque transfer? Torque transfer कितना हो जाएगा? Torque transfer कितना हो जाएगा? Friction force into RD, right? So torque transferred by each shoe will be equal to mu into m into rg into rd into omega 2 square minus omega 1 square, right? It will be ff into rd. So ye itti value aa jayegi, mu into m into rg into rd omega 2 square minus omega 1 square. Now this is the torque transferred by each shoe. Matlab har ek shoe itna torque transfer kar raha hai. So torque transferred by n number of shoes. Torque transferred by n number of shoes will be how much? N times of this. Yani n into mu into m into rg into rd into omega 2 square minus omega 1 square. Just multiply n. This is the torque transfer equation by one shoe. So the total number of shoes are n. So torque transferred by all the shoes will be equal to this much. N multiplied by this equation. N multiplied by this equation. Do you understand this? If you understand this, hit the like button right now. Agar aap sabko clear hai ye cheez, then hit the like button right now, beta. So this is the equation of torque transfer by a centrifugal clutch. Understand this, beta. Understand this. In this equation, whenever you will use this equation, omega 1 and omega 2 will always be in radian per second. RG and RD should always be in meter. यहां पे ये चीज ध्यान देना बेटा, इसमें भी in this equation also RG should be in meter. अदरवाइज योर आंसर विल बी रॉन्ग, ठीक है? आपका जो रेडियस है वो मीटर में होना चाहिए जब भी आप ये इक्वेशन यूज करोगे, ठीक है? वरना आपका आंसर गलत आएगा. अगर आप एमएम में रखोगे तो आंसर गलत आएगा. एंड इट इज वेरी सिंपल टू रिमेंबर दिस इक्वेशन. इट इज वेरी इजी टू रिमेंबर दिस इक्वेशन. मल्टीप्लाई एवरीथिंग इन ओमेगा टू स्क्वायर माइनस ओमेगा वन स्क्वायर. सारी चीजों को ओमेगा टू स्क्वायर माइनस ओमेगा वन स्क्वायर के साथ मल्टीप्लाई कर दो एंड यू विल गेट द इक्वेशन ऑफ टॉर्क ट्रांसफर. ओके, एन इंटू म्यू इंटू एम इंटू आर जी इंटू आर डी इंटू रूट इंटू ओमेगा टू स्क्वायर माइनस ओमेगा वन स्क्वायर. दिस इज द इक्वेशन ऑफ टॉर्क ट्रांसफर बाय अ सेंट्रिफ्यूगल क्लच. इज इट क्लियर टू एवरीवन? क्या ये चीज सबको क्लियर है? ये पॉइंट सबको क्लियर है? यस. Okay. So, beta, this is the equation of torque transfer by a centrifugal clutch. Ab, beta, in case of centrifugal clutch, the engagement and disengagement depends upon omega 1, right? Jo engagement or disengagement hai, wo omega 1 pe depend karta hai. Ab, omega 1 ko set kaise karte hai? How do we set the value of omega 1? Okay, let's say you are designing a centrifugal clutch for your Activa. Let's say you are designing centrifugal clutch for your vehicle. So now, beta, in order to engage and disengage the clutch at a particular speed, I need to set the value of omega 1. Maan lo, let's say I want the clutch to engage at 100 RPM. So how am I going to set the value of omega 1 equal to 100, value of omega 1 corresponding to 100 RPM. मैं इसको 100 RPM में कैसे सेट करूं? So बेटा, in order to set the value of omega 1, we need to set the value of stiffness. हम स्प्रिंग की स्टिफनेस को मैनिपुलेट करके ओमेगा वन मैनिपुलेट कर सकते हैं. वी कैन एडजस्ट द वैल्यू ऑफ ओमेगा वन बाय एडजस्टिंग द वैल्यू ऑफ स्टिफनेस. सो लेट्स सी व्हाट इज द रिलेशन बिटवीन ओमेगा वन एंड स्टिफनेस ऑफ स्प्रिंग. ओके सो बेटा स्प्रिंग फोर्स इज हाउ मच. मैक्सिमम स्प्रिंग फोर्स इज इक्वल टू एम आर जी ओमेगा वन स्क्वायर विच इज इक्वल टू स्टिफनेस इन टू मैक्सिमम डिफ्लेक्शन. राइट दिस इज द स्टिफनेस ऑफ स्प्रिंग. दिस इज द स्टिफनेस ऑफ स्प्रिंग. है ना स्प्रिंग स्टिफनेस इंटू मैक्सिमम डिफ्लेक्शन. दिस इज द स्प्रिंग फोर्स. नाउ बेटा ओमेगा वन स्क्वायर इज प्रपोर्शनल टू के और ओमेगा वन इज प्रपोर्शनल टू रूट ओवर के. सो बेटा डू यू अंडरस्टैंड द रिलेशन बिटवीन ओमेगा वन एंड के. इफ आई वॉन्ट टू एडजस्ट the value of omega 1, I will adjust the value of k. x maximum, maximum deflection will be fixed. ठीक है, based on the space, जितना space है आप जितना बड़ा क्लच बना रहे हो उसके हिसाब से आपका x maximum, maximum how much the spring will deflect, that is fixed. It cannot go beyond that ना. ऐसा तो है नहीं कि drum को फाड़ के spring निकल जाएगा, है कि नहीं? जितना drum तक पहुंचने के लिए length होगी उतनी ही deflect होगी ना spring, right? So बेटा x max is fixed. Let's say M and RG is also fixed. So my omega 1 will be proportional to K. So if K increases, omega 1 also increases. Okay, there has been a theory question based on this concept, beta, ki how the value of omega changes with respect to K. Omega jo hai wo K ke respect mein kaise change hota hai. So if I increase stiffness of spring, omega 1 will also increase. So by increasing the and decreasing the value of K, I can increase or decrease the value of omega. मैं k की वैल्यू को बड़ा घटा के ओमेगा को कम ज्यादा कर सकता हूं. I can manipulate the value of omega by manipulating the value of stiffness. Okay? So you need to remember this equation and you need to remember this relation. ठीक है, एक equation ये याद रखनी है टॉर्क की और एक ये relation याद रखना है आपको omega और k पे बीच में. Okay? So बेटा let's solve one numerical from centrifugal clutch. एक न्यूमेरिकल सॉल्व कर लेते हैं सेंट्रिफ्यूगल क्लच के ऊपर. ऑल्दो बेटा टिल नाउ देयर हैज ओनली बीन न्यूमेरिकल फ्रॉम प्लेट क्लच इन गेट. गेट में प्लेट क्लच के ऊपर ही न्यूमेरिकल आया है आज तक. सिंगल प्लेट एंड मल्टीप्लेट देयर हैज नेवर बीन अ क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम कोन क्लच एंड सेंट्रिफ्यूगल क्लच. बट स्टिल दिस इज इन आवर सिलेबस सो वी नीड टू स्टडी दीज टू क्लचेस. ओके, ये दोनों क्लच भी अपने सिलेबस में है तो अपने को ये पढ़ना है. थ्योरी क्वेश्चंस हैज बीन देयर. Theory questions has been there from cone clutch and centrifugal clutch. So it is not like they are not in our syllabus. The numericals have not been asked, but theory questions are there. ठीक है, ऐसा नहीं है कि gate में कभी आया नहीं है. ठीक है, theory question आया है. आप देख सकते हो खोल के theory question आपको दिख जाएगी. Theory question, conceptual questions are there, but numericals are not there. But बेटा ऐसे तो बहुत सारे topics से numerical नहीं आया है. Okay, तो ऐसा थोड़ी है कि वो topics अपन बिना पढ़े चले जाएंगे. Okay. So we need to cover every topic that is in our syllabus. Okay. So beta, let's see how to solve the numericals based on centrifugal clutch. You just need to remember this equation. Okay. Chalo. So beta, this is the question. Solve this problem. Is problem ko solve karke dikhao. Solve this problem, beta. Solve this problem quickly. जल्दी से सॉल्व करो. यस विवेक, यस, वेरी गुड. चलो सॉल्व करो. ओमेगा वन शुड बी ग्रेटर और लेसर. बेटा शिवम, दैट विल डिपेंड अपॉन योर एप्लीकेशन. ऐसा थोड़ी है कि ओमेगा वन ज्यादा या कम होना चाहिए. वो तो डिपेंड करेगा ना एप्लीकेशन पे. आप कौन से एप्लीकेशन के लिए यूज कर रहे हो, क्या आपको स्पीड रखनी है, वो उसके ऊपर डिपेंड करेगा. इससे सेंट्रिफ्यूगल क्लच को थोड़ी ना कोई नुकसान या फायदा होगा. देयर इज नो एडवांटेज और डिसएडवांटेज ऑफ कीपिंग ओमेगा वन लेस और ग्रेटर. इट डिपेंड्स अपॉन द एप्लीकेशन कि आप कौन से एप्लीकेशन के लिए ये क्लच डिजाइन कर रहे हो, आपको कितना रखना है ओमेगा पर. सॉल्व दिस. अ सेंट्रीफ्यूगल क्लच कंसिस्ट ऑफ फोर शूज ईच हैविंग अ मास ऑफ 1.5 केजी. इन द एंगेज्ड पोजीशन द रेडियस ऑफ सेंटर ऑफ ग्रेविटी ऑफ ईच शू इज 110 mm एंड इनर रेडियस ऑफ ड्रम इज 140. कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ फ्रिक्शन इज 0.3. द प्री लोड इन द स्प्रिंग इज एडजस्टेड इन सच अ वे that the spring force at the beginning of engagement is 700 newton. Okay. Running speed is 1440 rpm. Calculate the speed at which engagement begins and power transmitted by clutch at 1440 rpm. So, beta, first of all, give me the value of speed at which engagement begins. Now, how can we find the speed at which engagement begins? Beta, understand. They have given the maximum spring force. Maximum spring force यानी कि स्प्रिंग फोर्स एट द स्टार्ट ऑफ एंगेजमेंट. ओके, स्प्रिंग फोर्स एट द स्टार्ट ऑफ एंगेजमेंट. सो एफएस मैक्सिमम इज हाउ मच? एफएस मैक्सिमम की वैल्यू क्या होगी? एम आर जी ओमेगा वन स्क्वायर है कि नहीं? एफएस मैक्सिमम विल बी एम आर जी ओमेगा वन स्क्वायर. नाउ व्हाट इज एफएस मैक्सिमम हियर? 700 न्यूटन. नाउ व्हाट इज द मास ऑफ ईच शू? 1.5 kg. What is RG? Radius of center of gravity 110 mm. And I told you, you need to keep it in meter here. आपको यहाँ पे put करना है meter में. Don't put the value of RG in mm. I have already told you. तो omega 1 कितना आ रहा है बेटा? What is omega 1? Root over 700 divided by 1.5 into 0.11. So how much is omega 1? 65.13 रेडियन पर सेकेंड है ना. कैन आई कैलकुलेट दिस इन आरपीएम? क्या मैं इसको आरपीएम में कन्वर्ट कर सकता हूं? 65.13. ओमेगा 1 विल बी इक्वल टू 2 pi n1 by 60. इट इज 65.13. तो बेटा व्हाट इज n1? n1 कितना होगा आरपीएम में? व्हाट विल बी द वैल्यू? N1 will be how much? 65.13 into 60 divided by 2 pi. So how much are we getting? 621.94 RPM. है ना? RPM में अगर मैं value निकालूंगा, radian per second में it will be this and RPM में it will be this, 621.94 or almost 622 RPM. Almost 622 RPM. तो 622 RPM तक there will be no engagement. After 622 RPM, the clutch will engage. 622 RPM तक कोई engagement नहीं होगा और जैसे ही 622 RPM से थोड़ी भी स्पीड बढ़ेगी, the clutch will start moving, right? Okay, very good Shivam, Saurabh, Prem, very good Shekhar, Karthik, Saurabh, very good Nikhil, very good, बहुत बढ़िया प्रसाद, बहुत बढ़िया. सो बेटा नाउ लेट्स कैलकुलेट द सेकेंड थिंग, पावर ट्रांसफर्ड एट 1440 आरपीएम. सो बेटा आई नीड टू फर्स्ट फाइंड द टॉर्क ट्रांसफर. टॉर्क ट्रांसफर की इक्वेशन वेरी सिंपल, एन इंटू म्यू इंटू एम इंटू आर जी इंटू आर डी इंटू ओमेगा 2 स्क्वायर माइनस ओमेगा 1 स्क्वायर. अब ओमेगा 2 भी निकाल लेते हैं बेटा. व्हाट विल बी ओमेगा 2? 2 pi n2 by 60. And what is N2? What is the running speed? 1440 RPM. So what will be omega 2 beta? Omega 2 kitna ho jayega? 2 pi into 1440 by 60. So it is how much? 150.79 radian per second, right? So now beta, what will be torque transfer? N is what? Number of shoes. Mu is what? Coefficient of friction, which is 0.3. Mass of each shoe, 1.5. RG, radius of center of gravity, inner radius of drum, 0.14. Omega 2, 150.79. And omega 1, 65.13. So from here, I am going to get the torque transfer capacity. I am going to get the torque transfer capacity. So 4 into 0.3 into 1.5 into 0.11 into 0.14 इंटू 150.79 स्क्वायर माइनस 65.13 स्क्वायर, हाउ मच आर वी गेटिंग, कितना आ रहा है? यस विवेक, वेरी गुड, 512.7 न्यूटन मीटर, 512.7 न्यूटन मीटर. सो नाउ आई नीड टू फाइंड पावर. अब पावर कैसे मिलेगा बेटा? व्हाट विल बी पावर? पावर विल बी इक्वल टू टी इंटू ओमेगा 2. तो टी कितना है? 512.7. ओमेगा 2 कितना है? 150.79. ओके, ओमेगा 2 मतलब 2 पाई n2 बाय 60. ठीक है, तो या तो आप n के टर्म्स में रख लो या तो ओमेगा के टर्म्स में रख लो. इधर यू कैन पुट इट इन टर्म्स ऑफ n और यू कैन पुट इट इन टर्म्स ऑफ ओमेगा, इट इज योर विश. 77310 और यू कैन से पावर इक्वल टू 77.31 किलोवाट. 77.31 किलोवाट. वेरी गुड विवेक, वेरी गुड, वेरी गुड, वेरी गुड यासर, वेरी गुड, बहुत बढ़िया, बहुत बढ़िया शेखर, वेरी गुड, वेरी गुड बेटा, वेरी गुड, बहुत बढ़िया. सो एवरीवन इज क्लियर अबाउट दिस कॉन्सेप्ट? सबसे बन गया ये वाला सवाल. वेरी गुड प्रेम, वेरी गुड महादेव प्रसाद, वेरी गुड सौरभ, वेरी गुड विवेक, बहुत बढ़िया, बहुत बढ़िया, बहुत बढ़िया यासर. तो इसी बात पे बेटा हिट द लाइक बटन, वी आर एट 94 नंबर ऑफ लाइक्स, प्लीज मेक इट बियॉन्ड 100, 100 के ऊपर लेके जाओ. Very good. Thank you so much, guys. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. So, is everyone clear about the construction and working of centrifugal clutch? Bahut badhiya, Sumit. Bahut badhiya, Subramani. Chalo, 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 chalo. So, beta, with this, we end the design of clutch. So, humne clutch mein padha, beta. What is clutch? What are the different types of clutch? Positive clutch and friction clutch. We saw the difference between them. Then we saw three types of friction clutch: plate clutch, cone clutch, and centrifugal clutch. Plate clutch and cone clutch, they are one category of clutch. Now understand this, beta. Plate clutch and cone clutch, they are also known as radial clutch. Plate clutch or cone clutch ko, inko radial clutch bhi bolte hain. Why, beta? Why they are known as radial clutch? Because the force is acting radially. Sorry. इनको axial clutch बोलते हैं. Sorry. मैंने गलत बोल दिया. I'm so sorry. These are known as axial clutch. इनको axial clutch क्यों बोलते हैं बेटा? Because the force of engagement W is axial. ठीक है? And beta, centrifugal clutch is known as radial clutch. Centrifugal clutch is known as radial clutch. Why? Because force FC minus FS is radial. Jo force develop hota hai in order to engage the shoe, that force is radial na. Yahan pe dekho beta, yahan pe force kaisa develop hota hai? If this is the clutch, the force is in this direction, axial. And beta, in centrifugal clutch, if this is the clutch, the force is in this direction, radial, hai na? So beta, the force in plate clutch and cone clutch is axial, the force is in centrifugal clutch is radial. That's why these two are known as axial clutch and this is known as radial clutch. Theek hai? Okay, so beta, we have seen single plate clutch, multi plate clutch, cone clutch, and today we saw centrifugal clutch. In sabka, I have shown you the animation, I have shown you the real life images. I have shown you the construction and working, and I have derived the equation of torque for every clutch in the class, and we have also solved numericals. Now beta, in order to solve more numericals, we have a daily practice problem session on Unacademy free special class. Unacademy free special class today at 9 p.m. 9 baje abhi 9 baje we have a special class DPP of clutch where we are going to solve numericals of clutch and I am also going to solve a few theory question. आज मैं आपके लिए थोड़े थ्योरी क्वेश्चन भी करने वाला हूं ताकि आप लोगों को कंसेप्चुअल क्वेश्चन थ्योरी क्वेश्चंस भी प्रैक्टिस हो जाए. थैंक यू सो मच गाइस. सो बेटा टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सॉल्व द न्यूमेरिकल्स एंड थ्योरी प्रॉब्लम्स कंसेप्चुअल प्रॉब्लम्स ऑफ क्लच ऑल द क्लचेस सेंट्रिफ्यूगल क्लच कोन क्लच प्लेट क्लच ऑल द क्लचेस एट 9 पीएम. सो डोंट फॉरगेट टू कम टू दिस क्लास DPP class at 9 p.m. on Unacademy. It's a special class on Unacademy which is completely free of cost. You just need to download the learning app or you just go to unacademy.com on your laptop. ठीक है? So, beta, how will you find the link of this class? Go to tinyurl.com/approve10. Go to tinyurl.com/approve10. You will have A Excel sheet of DPP. आपको DPP की एक Excel sheet मिलेगी, where you will see the title of the class, date and time of the class, and link of the class. Okay. So, beta, we are going to solve numericals as well as conceptual questions of clutch at 9 p.m. today, beta. And you will also find the Excel sheet of engineering mechanics and machine design, where, beta, lecture by lecture, you will see the YouTube class link. And the PDF link. So you can download the PDF of every lecture and you can also watch the YouTube class directly from here. Just by clicking on it, you will get the YouTube class. Okay. So beta, just go to tinyurl.com/approve10 and bookmark this Excel sheet. It will work as a digital book for you. Engineering mechanics already completed 38 lectures. And machine design is ongoing. So we have completed 2 chapters of machine design, brakes and clutch. Okay, and soon we are going to cover the entire syllabus of machine design. Pura syllabus cover karne wale machine design ka. Theek hai? And beta, if you want to study with me, come to Unacademy Plus subscription. Beta, 21st September se. From 21st September, we are going to start a new crash course from 21st September. From 21st September, crash course for GATE. Crash course for GATE 2021. Okay. And this crash course will be taken by The top educators of Unacademy, only the selected top educators of Unacademy are going to take this crash course. I am one of them. Devendra Singh Negi sir is one of them. So, beta, only the top educators of Unacademy Mechanical Engineering are going to take this crash course from 21st September GATE 2021 ke liye. We are going to complete the syllabus in 2 to 3 months, beta, 2 months maximum, 2 to 3 months. We will complete the entire syllabus of GATE, beta, and it's a crash course. Okay, it's a crash course. So it is going to help you to get that under 1000 rank, under 500 rank. Wo jo aapka rank booster hai, we will boost your rank by at least 25 to 30%. If you attend this crash course, beta, it is going to be really advantageous because this is taken by the top educators of India. So if you want to join this crash course from 21st September, take the plus subscription. If you want to know more about it, contact me, beta, anyhow, and you will get to know more about it. So you can see the multiple batches running on Unacademy and you can join any one of them. Aap inme se koi sa bhi join kar sakte hain. You just need to take one subscription. How to take that subscription, beta? Go to Unacademy Learning app, go to plus, choose GATE and ESE as your goal and click on get subscription. Now, beta, if you only want crash courses or revision, then 1 month, 3 months, 6 months. Otherwise, beta, if you want to complete your syllabus, if you want to complete your education, if you want to complete your preparation, take 1 year or 2 year subscription. There is one more advantage. Per month cost is very less in 1 year and 2 year subscription. But don't forget to use this approved 10 as your referral code. If you use this referral code, you are going to get 10% instant off, and beta, 1 year fee will become only 22,500. 2 year fee will become only 27,000. What will be the advantage? If you use this code, beta, you are going to get 10% off. And as soon as you use this code, you will be connected to me. I will be notified and you will be connected to me. I am going to guide you throughout the preparation. I am going to tell you which batches to join, which subject to join, which educator to follow. I am going to tell you everything on Unacademy, beta. So beta, don't forget to put this as your referral code and join Unacademy Plus and take this crash course, which is starting from 21st September. There are top educators of India of mechanical engineering teaching in this crash course. And you can pay this fees in EMI also. Credit card pay, debit card pay, Bajaj Finance ke card pay, there is EMI option available. And beta, your fee will become only 1875 rupees per month. 1 year subscription only in 1875 rupees per month or 60 rupees per day. That's it. But don't forget to use this code APPROVED10. As soon as you use this code, you will get connected to me. And I'm going to guide you throughout your preparation. Thank you so much. We will meet at 9 p.m. Don't forget about the DPP session at 9 p.m.